Your friends, the chancel choir of First Presbyterian Church, a new and glorious morn.
Thank you.
Christmas is a season of light and color, of joy and hope. It is a season punctuated by the laughter of children and the excited whispers of anticipation. A season accompanied by ageless melodies, proclaiming tidings of goodwill and peace on earth.
It is a time to rejoice and celebrate the fulfillment of promises, the promise of a new day, of a new life, the promise of a Messiah, a newborn king.
But it was not always that way. There was a time before this king arrived that God's chosen people, the children of Israel, lived in a hopeless and dark world, a world of anguish and bondage, with little assurance of a bright tomorrow.
But words of hope continued to be proclaimed by the prophets of the day. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned.
Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes with the morning.
Prepare for the coming of the Lord. Make straight in the wilderness a highway for our God, and the glory of the Lord will be revealed. Messiah. They yearned for a king who, as King David had described, would rule out of reverence for God, one who would dawn on them like the morning light, like the sun shining forth on a cloudless morning.
The prophet Isaiah offered hope for the dawning of that new day when this righteous king would arrive. The Lord himself will give you a sign. A young maiden will give birth to a son and call him Emmanuel, which means God with us.
This king would be a source of profound light and life to all people. The sun shall no longer be your light by day, nor the brightness of the moon your light by night, but the Lord will be your everlasting light. Your God will be your glory.
This was the hope to which Israel clung as they awaited the dawning of a new and glorious morn, the arrival of the promised King of Heaven.
Joseph.
The angel told Mary, that she had found favor with God, and that she would conceive and give birth to the child that Isaiah had foretold hundreds of years before, the promised Messiah.
"How can this be?" Mary asked the angel. Gabriel responded, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The power of the Most High will overshadow you. This holy child shall be called the Son of God."
In those days, a decree was issued by Caesar Augustus that a census was to be taken of the entire Roman world. Everyone was to return to their hometown to register.
Joseph, to whom Mary was engaged, was from Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of King David. So he and Mary, who by then was great with child, made their way to Bethlehem.
Sometimes light emerges from the most obscure of places, bringing hope and promise in the darkest and most unlikely of settings. That was God's plan, as this trek to Bethlehem helped fulfill the words of the prophet Micah. "You, Bethlehem, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come one who will be ruler over Israel."
So it was that in God's perfect timing, the promised king, love's pure light, the Messiah, was born in the tiny village of Bethlehem.
Jesus, the long-awaited Messiah, was born.
As John, the beloved disciple and gospel writer, describes it, the Word, meaning Jesus, became flesh, made his dwelling among us. In him was life, and that life was the light for all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it.
The Bible records that there were shepherds living out in the fields near Bethlehem, keeping watch over their flocks at night. It was just an ordinary night, with ordinary shepherds doing ordinary things.
However, this night instantly became like no other night, as an angel of the Lord appeared to them. With the glory of the Lord shining all around them, the shepherds were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among all people." Could it be that shepherds, these shepherds would uniquely connect with the newborn Messiah who would one day call himself the Good Shepherd.
When the angels had left them and returned to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, about which the Lord has told us."
So they hurried off, found Mary and Joseph, and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Treasured up all these things as she pondered them in her heart.
Prophets, angels, shepherds, a census, calling them to the remote village of Bethlehem, and here, in a lowly stable, a newborn child, her child, and yet not exactly her child, at least not in the usual manner.
Into a dark and cold world, heaven's glorious light had shined in the most unlikely manner, in the most unlikely way. God had sent his very own to redeem the world, to provide life, and life abundant.
This was indeed a holy moment, a holy night.
Thank you.
The prophets had anticipated the day when the eternal light of heaven would shine upon the world. After centuries of waiting, the day of Messiah's birth had finally arrived.
This was the Messiah who would one day call himself the light of the world, the one who claimed that those who followed him would never walk in darkness.
This was the Messiah, the Savior, who would one day challenge his followers to be light in a world of darkness, to shine before others, and to show those others their good deeds, that they might give praise to the Father in heaven.
This Messiah, Jesus the Christ, has called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. He now reigns with his Father in heaven.
But he will return to gather his children to live forevermore in a place where there will be no more night. There will be no need for the light of a lamp or the light of the sun, for the Lord God will be the source of light.
Arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you.
Oh,